This is one of my favorite places in the gallery, and it would be an honor to read you a piece of my work in this place. Let's just have a quick look. See, which one's colorful? Should we go next to that?
Yeah.
Equal opportunity forms. I look in the mirror that echoes the features of my face. The perfectionist reflection has her teeth chained in the brace. Hair tied back with intertwined black velvet and lace. Armed with a CV packed with experiences ready to retrace. A complete list of essential and desired credential to embrace. From all that they can ask, they question only about the race. The mirror tells me that I've gambled without an ace.
I think هذا نحط بجوات هذا two bags.
هاي هاي literally
you're just
yeah.
I'll come and help you all individually.
Yeah, yeah.
What's the
whole
setup? Yes, here we go.
Not too far.
Very important to artists because artists should keep in touch with a local and international artist movement all the time.
I found it first of all, really, really inspiring because you get to learn from every woman. Every woman has got something to learn from.
And they encourage me and help me to showing some things. But I will be happy. Just now I am very happy attending to this group.
There's a very deep connection between the situation between with women and across the world. So I can say there is a same language for us. We can understand each other more. And being in this group is, to me, is like a gift because we can share in our experience, we can inspire by each other.
Feel like I'm very easy to get along with them. I feel like they are my sisters. We can share a lot of ideas, experiences, even though we are actually quite different.
I can hear, you know, different voice of women. Just, you know, we have the same issues. And because our root is, the same, we can understand each other.
We share many things, which are the most important things. Hardship and perseverance and resilience. And so I think that that is what gets us together.
Because people have such different experiences of oppression, I guess. It keeps opening up and opening up and opening up, and I find that really exciting. So the flip side is it's important to me that we're women artists, but that we're also culturally diverse women artists. And I couldn't separate which one of those is more important.
Thank you.
And over the last few months, what I've learnt is more than just obviously getting into these spaces, which is very, very valuable, but at the same time, the most valuable part of it for me has been meeting people, meeting artists from very different backgrounds and learning from their cultures, things that I probably wouldn't have come across before.
People said that it's like a sisterhood, and it is. It's a kind of a particular joy to be part of it. And it has, and that itself has not necessarily got anything to do with the art production, but being with artists is inspiring, and I think that's very nurturing.
I think what's been just so rich and exciting for me, in a very kind of selfish way, I guess, again, actually, is just finding out about all of your work and sort of being like, you know, just, you know, when you send me stuff through on emails or writings, or, I mean, I just feel like, oh, this is just great. It's kind of absorbing myself in all of your work and the richness of it, and realizing that richness is really missing, like in some of the exhibitions I see on a kind of day-to-day basis, or your voices are missing.
Quite often, everything else that I did, or quite a lot of other things that I did, made me feel like a mushroom. Because you know how when it rains or it's moist, the mushrooms appear and then suddenly they disappear? Yeah. And with occasions, let's say Refugee Week or things like that, I would get lots of people interested in my work, and then suddenly when that event is over, the whole interest or everything dies down. So that's how I felt, like a mushroom coming up with a special occasion but disappearing as fast as I appeared, or rather the interest to my work appeared.
I had several times, one from coming from Alice actually. She said, "I didn't really expect your work to be so good." Which means that they had already preconceived ideas of what was going to do. So one of the positive things is that we have come out, unfortunately, for very short times and proved that there is quality here. But there was, when I hear those comments, it really sort of offended me, because why would they not think that we are good? I mean, why do they call us then? You know,
just to tick a box.
Exactly.
It's creepy. I mean, you see something and you cannot put your finger on it. That, and you know it's racism. And it's so subtle, but you I feel it in my stomach. I just,
microaggressions.
I cannot explain to anybody how I received it.
Which is why
I just
know.
It's just sometimes just the way of just a glance, or, you know, it's very subtle. So it's not always necessarily like a white man just with tattoos saying, you know,
no, that,
a false
the majority
of times,
like
it's not,
it's just very subtle.
Because we all receive it, actually, as individuals. You know, I walk through the world as a black woman and I receive it emotionally, personally, in my face. Like, all of us do that.
Artists are not just there to obey, we have to rebel.
با این وجود بلند می شوم. مایا آنجلو said, "Leaving behind nights of terror and fear, I rise into a daybreak that's wondrously clear. I rise, bringing the gifts that my ancestor gave. I'm the dream and the hope of a slave. I rise, I rise, I rise. I'm looking at you. But then you look at me, Which country does she come from, yeah? What color is her skin? I'm looking at you. You're digging my mouth. What shape is it? What background is her mouth coming from? And I'm still looking at you. And here, you have questions. You have questions, don't you?
Literally swimming in racist water. So let me connect that to myself. As a result of being raised as a white person in this society, I have a racist worldview. We make it so miserable for people of color. I have developed racist patterns, and I have investments in a system of racism because it's served me really well. It's comfortable, it's helped me overcome the barriers that I do face. And I also have an investment on seeing that.
Look at this! Eve, the first feminist. She is curious, active, independent, and wise. She takes control and responsibility. She is the one confronting the serpents. She is our leader, our heroine.
My brother.
You can hear her. She's crying.
My body. It's my temple. It's my body.
I have never ever dreaded death, though its hands have always been more fragile than banality. My fear, however, was of dying in a land where grave diggers' wages are higher than the price of human freedom. This was the great absence. This was the story of ruin. If only freedom could sing a song. Small. Small, even smaller than the throat of a bird. It's only truth that is liberating.
I made the work that had to be made. We artists, you have our names in your pamphlet. Here we are for one day only. Down the road at the Whitworth, you can see our collaborations with Alice Kettle until February 2019. That show opened less than 2 weeks ago, alongside another show. Two exhibitions, one preview. The director of the Whitworth spent an hour singing the praises of one of the artists, the white man, and barely 10 minutes acknowledging Alice Kettle, the white female woman. We, he chose not to mention. He had our names written down on a piece of paper. In the 18th year of the 21st century, it appears the director of the Whitworth Oh, and Manchester Art Gallery, him being one and the same, couldn't do this. Shahire Sharif, Meyok Wong, Mabube Rajabi, Kani Kamul, Ekua Bayunu, Ana Lucia Cuevas, Calda Ahamri, Manya Ahamri, Gloria Sayer, Shaheda Chowdhury, Monica Rajani, Roxana Allison, Firuze Fazuni, Yusra Wasama, Aida Furutan, Anya Miko
Aijing.
So, wrapped up here is my work. Women hold up half the sky. Beautiful, challenging, inspiring. We are amazing artists.
I love the subversive nature of it, that whole thing around saying that women artists have been excluded, invisible, the way it's been curated, and the variety of artists and the variety of art forms. I thought it was wonderful.
Really made you think about the issues that were raised a lot of the time. I mean, the fact that the exhibits themselves are really interesting and creative and beautiful to look at, you know, that whole performance aspect of it was, I think, very involving and a really good idea.
I suppose the most powerful part of it was hearing marginalised people call out institutions for the things that they do. It's really nice to hear people not being complicit in that kind of system, but being confident in saying when it's wrong.
Though our project was about raising our profile and with these organisations, from my perspective, it's been more interesting in what is uncovered in those organisations because they have disconnected from the world that they serve.
Yeah.
There is no connection. So I think because of the way we work and who we are, I think that has exposed it because we're probably asking different questions. We have a different requirement from those spaces to the ones they're usually about.
Yeah, it's just so frustrating. How do you get them out there? How do you actually get them more mainstream at the same time as not, like you say, having to work within the rules of those mainstream galleries, you know, and have to kind of, you know, your own integrity comes into question. How do you do that? How do you at the same time? I mean, I think Akua said it brilliantly to me at one point about how do you kind of maintain or hold your head high within those organisations at the same time as trying to change them or trying to, you know, influence their practices in a different way. So I don't think this project is the end of that. I think for me it was very much about how do you start that process, how do you potentially try and get a group of different artists together that can work through those problems collectively.
It's a learning process as well as something that you go into to produce something, and I have learned quite a lot from this group.
If we work together, we have a louder voice. We have more resources, more experience and skills to achieve a bigger goal.
I have no doubt that we are going to carry on. It just, and I know that we are already thinking about, I'm not going to say it here, but I know that we have a future.
Centre of International Women Artists. Siwa?
Which? Siwa.
And Siwa means?
Siwa is Polish word, which means power, strength.
So that's coincidental, just, but we like that.
It's just amazing. When I first was sounding it out. It's just, I thought, oh my God, Shiwa.
We are converting this space into a set of studio spaces for individual artist practice, individual women artists, with a large portion of it reserved as a shared space, which will also be then offered residencies both for women based in Manchester who aren't here on a regular basis, but also for women from across the world. So we have a plan, and the plan is up on the wall, for some of the sort of activity that came out of us pooling our ambitions and our ideas for the next 3 years. Having a space means that we can start actioning our ideas, our desires in terms of our work, our responses to society, without having to seek the permission from actually a society that's part of what we're trying to shape and change.
From a white man.
Yeah, basically.
Basically.
Well, not basically, but part of that, yes.